Welcome to Kuya Noy's Love Clinic. This is an online clinic wherein we will talk about love in a universal aspect. From agape love, the love of God to man, filial love, the familial and friendly love, and the eros love, the sexual and worldly love. In this vlog, we will be answering one question every day, and this question will be from the viewers and streamers themselves that we call vlogmates. If you wish to join by asking questions, you can go to the messenger and search for the name Gonzaga Hedon, that is G-O-N-Z-A-G-A space H-E-D-U-N. This is the one with the RN insignia. Then send your questions there. If you do not want your name to be read as the sender, please indicate what alias or pseudonym will be utilized for you. Remember, this is our program. I will just be your host and I will just share life's great lessons both from the academe and from experience. So don't forget to support this advocacy by hitting the subscribe button in the YouTube vlog video if you are not yet a subscriber, and pray for the success of our program. Once again, this is Kuya Noy's Love Clinic. Good day everyone, this is Kuya Noy and you are watching the Love Clinic. Our question for today goes this way. I usually believe in asking for signs when it comes to love. Oftentimes, signs become coincidental already, but I still believe in those signs even if it is illogical. Is there something wrong with this? Our question sender is Jeffrey, not his real name, 20 years old, from Mandawi City, Cebu Province, Philippines. Dear vlogmates, asking for signs is actually a thing that we derive from biblical origin, of which prophets would like to have a hint from God on what to do when they are guiding people. This is of course because God has commanded them to lead his people. So they are just asking for the next move. However, if you come to think of it, there is also an encryption in the Bible which signifies that God will never mess with free will. In fact, God will always honor our decisions and our choices. This is one of the great powers that God may have given humanity because of His great love for us. Together with His power is a great responsibility on how to use this in a way that we will be reflecting God's character of love. Now, ask yourself if you are also haunted by these questions in your mind. Number one, by asking for a sign, is that God's way of telling me what to do? Number two, are the signs that are appearing and fronting us legitimate signs, or are they just there due to coincidence or normal progressions of time? Number three, will God make a decision through a sign and apply that to you? Dear vlogmates, if you are one of those people who are asking one or more of the questions that I have stated earlier, then this vlog is also for you. Let us try to lay down the clear answers on the truth behind the asking for signs in love. Before I continue, this has been your Kuya Noy, and this is still your favorite program, The Love Clinic. I am very happy to tell you that there are already consistent young people who are intently waiting for the newer episodes of The Love Clinic. However,
The Love Clinic is a sub-production of Jervin Eagle Viewpoints Vlog. And under this vlog, we are also producing other sub-productions, namely Diabiligence, a vlog that gives tips and suggestions for diabetic people and people who are caring for diabetic population. Another sub-production is Istoryahe. This is a vernacular presentation of issues in a comical presentation yet intellectually beefing up our minds regarding present-day situational issues and concerns. Another sub-production is Tito Noy's Story R. This is a sub-production for children aging 5 to 15 years of age, yet it can also be used by older people as these are inspirational stories with moral lessons interjected. These are the sub-productions that we are producing on alternating basis. And if you are subscribed to the YouTube channel of Mr. Noy Gonzaga, you can access all of these productions. So what are you waiting for? Hit that word subscribe now under this video if you are not yet subscribed to our channel so that you will have access to our informative productions. As of this moment, I have chosen Galatians 5:13 as our Bible verse for the hour. It says, "For you were called to freedom, brothers and sisters. Only do not use your freedom as an opportunity for the flesh, but through love, serve one another." This verse concretely points out that man was given freedom, but this was given with a reminder to be used for fairness and not for getting advantage over others. Freedom was given by God and should be used with responsibility, logic, fairness to humanity. If we will equate this in the field of love, love is always destined to be a principle, a logical choice, a practically rational idea, not merely a destiny surprisingly chosen because of an illogical way of asking for a sign. What to do with regards to a concern in a relationship. Now let us define some terminologies here. Sign. Sign is defined as a congruence or similarity to the event or things being specified in a wish by a person asking for it. Meaning, if one person is asking for a sign, which is, example, rain, and if rain will fall, she will answer yes to a proposing boyfriend. Oftentimes, this is very trivial, as if you are the person involved in the relationship, you should have qualifications or met objectives as basis for your decisions. Not merely a coincidental event like the rain, for in the first place, the rain will never solve your problem in that relationship in the future. There is a big difference between fate and coincidence, but they are all embodied in a baseless projection of people who are asking for signs in the things that they will do for their lives, especially in the field of love. Oftentimes, these are not just simple things, but those that are life and future defining situations. Here, let us try to analyze three great factual points that has the essence of asking for a sign. So let us try to analyze these three great factual points. Let me identify them first. Number one, asking for a sign is actually an insult to the intellect and cognitive capacity of the brain to make decisions about love based on evidences and reason. Number two, asking for a sign is an escape from a possible judgment. Thus, due to fear of being narrowed down in the blame, a sign is being diverted to in order to take the blame for decisions that may go wrong. Number three, asking for a sign is making love trivial, baseless, unfounded, and much more worse, comical. Now, dear vlogmates, let us take these facts one by one and give brief elaborations for each of them. So number one, asking for a sign is actually an insult to the intellect and cognitive capacity of the brain to make decisions about love based on evidence and reasons. Yes, man is given the five senses, namely the sense of seeing, hearing, smelling, touching, and tasting, in order to collect valid facts that will translate into intellectual inputs in the brain. Thus, this will also apply to love. When you love someone, you have to know what the eyes will say. Is he or she beautiful or handsome? Is he or she attractive internally and externally? When you love someone, you should hear what the ears will say. Is he or she sensible in the way he or she communicates? When you love someone, you should smell what the nose would like to say. If he or she is practicing hygiene as determined if there was an occurrence of an armpit smell. Well, these are just examples of how the five senses can work to our advantage in the production of evidences of facts that will lead us to decide whether to say yes or no to the person that we love. It's not a mere sign of, okay? When the next vehicle that will pass will be colored white, then I will say yes. Is there any logic or sense to this kind of decision making? Are the signs valid or just colorum in this specified scenario? Number two, asking for a sign is an escape from a possible judgment, just thus, due to fear of being narrowed down in the blame, a sign is being diverted to in order to take the blame for decisions that may go wrong. Oftentimes, we already know what our mind has to say and what evidences do we have in our thinking. But we fear that our decisions will be used by others to blame us, or worse is, if our decision will be emotionally wrong but in principle right. So because of this tug of war in the thinking, signs are being asked so that there will be someone or something to blame if things or events go wrong. Not necessarily that it can go direct to us because the sign stays at the middle. This is one way of fooling ourselves or creating a world that is imaginary to the actual and present world where we exist. Oftentimes, these are just delaying tactics to confront reality. Number three, asking for a sign is making love trivial, baseless, unfounded, and comical. While you are bounded by evidence as seen by the five senses of the body through the eyes, ears, nose, skin, and mouth, you choose to neglect the evidences on hand and put your decision at the mercies of coincidences and superstitions in some points. Well, let me elaborate on this. One, you are about to make a decision to marry someone. Now, you have a concrete evidence as seen with your eyes and heard with your ears that your husband-to-be has already affairs with other people even before your marriage. You choose not to see these evidences as heavy, but rather, you one day tell yourself, if he will come today to fetch me on a date and he will wear purple or violet, then I will forget the facts because the sign is for him to wear a violet clothing or dress, then I will accept the offer for marriage. Needless to say, this is a very wrong and stupid decision. However, stupidity is harsh, and that is why we hide it in the term asking for a sign. Yes, dear vlogmates, the points that I may have driven are hurting and painful, but oftentimes we need to feel pain to know that we are still alive and not merely numb to the trap of illogical decision makings in the avenue of love. Now, for my personal viewpoint and humble opinion, love should be dealt with facts. There are always incidences of gamble, because young people of today consider thrill of the unknown as exciting. The fact that you have an unknown frontage makes that a dangerous thing to consider. Let us not put our fate, our relationship issues, and our capacity to love in the gambling essence of asking for a sign. Because in the first place, God declared already that He will always respect our free will. If God will intervene with the sign, then that is messing up with the choices and decisions of men, which is not a character of God. So always remember, that is why our heads are placed above our hearts, so that the head can put order and organization above the thrill and sentimentalism of the heart. Let us always decide, because we have proof to consider why we reach such a decision. Let us not decide by gambling fate so that we will have suspense in what will happen. Remember, we are not talking here about a game in the laptop or in the tablet. We are talking here about lives, and failure to consider the logical reasons may mean the separation of success and failure in the future life. Now, the direct answer to the question of our question sender. Let me first read the question. I usually believe in asking for signs when it comes to love. Oftentimes, signs become coincidental already, but I still believe in those signs even if it is illogical. Is there something wrong with this? This is from Jeffrey, not his real name, 20-year-old from Mandawi City, Cebu Province, Philippines. There is really something wrong with that, Jeffrey, to be honest. Let us not put our future in the gambling table by waiting for those signs. Let us paint the future and work hard and do our honest best, because with clean intentions and industrious spirit, people accomplish the best for their future, and that includes the best possible option for a relationship and even a foundation for a happier and heavenly bounded familial and love considerations. Let me end today's vlog with a quotation from Ellen Gold Harmon White, a prophetess of the Seventh-day Adventist Church, who authored hundreds of books regarding Christian lifestyle and principles. The quotation goes this way: true love is a high and holy principle, altogether different in character from that love which is awakened by impulse and which suddenly dies when severely tested. This is a very, very timely quotation by Sister Ellen Gold Harmon White. Yes, true love will really go beyond the test of time. To our vlogmate Jeffrey, your question is very timely. so that we can correct some impressionist idea about love in terms of gambling the faith of love and even founding love in the essence of irrational human actuations. Again, thank you for this question. There are many young people who have the same query. That is why they were also blessed with the inputs and ideas that have been discussed in this episode of Love Clinic. And that is because of your kindness to send your question. Question sender, Jeffrey. Thank you. Now, before the Love Clinic will close, permit Kuya Noy to offer a special prayer for Jeffrey and for all the young people out there who have the same question. Shall we pray? Lord, thank you for reminding us to use our critical thinking and godly intellect to decide for things that will benefit our lives. Help us, Lord, to remember not to leave our faith to things that are unsure, unfounded, and unrealistic. Because you have given us the chance to make our own choices and decisions with the use of our mind. Thank you, Lord, for all these blessings. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen and amen. To all who are asking for signs about their love and faith of the relationship, make that decision based on the logical and practical evidences that are present and absorbed by your five senses. It's time to stop gambling our capacity to love. Rather, it is time to love in principle, intellect, foundation, and above everything else, love the way God has founded the essence of true love when He created the world. Have a great day again to all of our lovers. And at this moment, we are now closing the Love Clinic. God bless and have a great day, beloved vlogmates.